Very sunny corner of Glenwood and Lunt. We are in the heart of Rogers Park. We're up here on the stage once again at the Heartland Cafe, where every Saturday morning we bring you another edition of the Live from the Heartland show. I'm Michael James, and I'm the host this morning. My co-host Katie Hogan is off doing some political work for the president, and we wish her and the president well. Last night I was coming back from my son Cadian's graduation from Jones Community College Prep, which was a wonderful event held at the Auditorium Theater. And as we drove back, he said, "I love Rogers Park. It's so cozy and, what was the other word he used?" He said, "Cozy and bustling." Rogers Park is the place that's cozy and bustling. And that's true right here on the corner of Glenwood and Lunt. You're welcome to run right over or bike right over and join the live listening audience. Or if you have to move about and you go out of radio range, which is 88.7 FM, you can go to www.org. And earlier editions are always available at youtube.com/heartlandmedia. When I say lovely corner, they are working on it to make it even more lovely. We're getting a new L stop or a rebuilding, so there's a lot of construction going on. Don't be put off by construction. Sometimes it's an inconvenience, but we've been crying for infrastructure repair everywhere in the nation. We want to create those jobs, and when it comes, there is an inconvenience. So you may have to bike, you may have to walk, you may have to run, you may have to crawl, but you can get here anytime you want to get here. So let's get started. We're going to have a good show this morning. I didn't have anyone booked for this morning until a few days ago, so I was putting the word out to many, many people, and I actually lined up future shows. But this morning we got both Lucy Smith and Kathy Pollock. They're going to talk to us about Artists of the Wall, which is going to have its 19th season next weekend. A little bit later we're going to have my old buddy Alan Gomez, who had emailed me about some communal living group there, or house that he's been involved with, and I asked him to come, but he's also involved in a town called Choco, Colombia, dealing with economically in challenged folks, and he's going to talk to us about that. We're going to have our good buddy and sometimes co-host Tom Clark talk to us a little bit about the aftermath of the NATO presence in our town. And I've got some real old friends. They're not that old. Well, they're not a little younger than me, probably. That would be Omar Lopez and Carol Lee. And they're going to talk to us about the Chicago Latino Coalition 2020 History Project, an art exhibit, a photo exhibit of Division Street 66, and other events. They're going to have a program today, and we'll hear all about it. So let's get going. Good morning to you, Lucy and Kathy. How are you?
Good morning, Michael.
Thank you.
It's great to have you up here on the stage. I think you've both been here before.
Oh, yeah.
And we always like having you, because I know Kathy bumps up our ratings whenever she's on talking about the Greenleaf Art Gallery. Is that what it's called?
Art Center.
Art Center down there on Greenleaf, just west of Ravenswood on Greenleaf. That would be, what's the address?
1806 West Greenleaf.
Well, whenever she's on the show, we get a lot of hits on the YouTube, so let's just keep pumping it up. All right, so we're here today to talk about Artists of the Wall. Who wants to start? Tell us what it is, what's happening, when.
Well, we're here to invite everyone to come to the beach next weekend for Artists of the Wall. It's the 19th annual, and it's a wonderful, it's also Father's Day, so it's a wonderful day for the family. I brought my family with me today to remind me to tell people to bring their kids, their dogs, their neighbors, their husbands, their fathers, everybody to the Artists of the Wall next weekend.
Coming.
This year, our theme, I'm glad you're coming.
Usually I'm in Texas at the basketball in the barrio, but it's a week later and I may or may not go. So I'm going to show up on the wall, and maybe I'll even buy, if I can, I'll buy a little chunk of wall and paint a picture.
We can't wait to see that.
You'll be happy.
This year's theme is barefoot in the sand. And so the theme of the wall kind of goes along with the theme of the whole festival. And I can't decide what we're going to paint. I'm thinking something. I always like to try and work art into it, you know, so making art in the sand, I don't know what will happen. Anyway, it's always fun to see what the wall turns out to be. It's actually 143 separate art projects, and it covers 5,000 square feet of the, it's like a 5,000 square foot mural on the beach. It's awesome.
Is it always 143 segments?
No. Sometimes the spaces change shape a little bit. It's getting so popular, it's hard to get a space now. You should pre-register, but we do have some that will be available on Saturday morning.
And how would you pre-register?
Well, you can go to rogerspark.com for a link, or you can, I guess, ask one of us. Oh, yeah, you can also email. We do have an email address.
And what is that email address?
Laura, what is that email address?
We got Laura and Gary, some people who listen regularly. They're actually here in the live listening audience today. And we'll get that email by the end of the segment.
All right, we will. Write it down for
me. Well, I'm wondering, as we speak, is there a regular, or is there a film or video of multi-years? Has anyone put anything together? I know people take pictures. Some people
Yeah, I know
video.
There's a lot of still shots. And I don't know if anyone's organized a film. I know Lucy has some pictures from last year of the entertainment, which, you know, is really a huge part of the event. And we have a good many pictures from over the years through the Art Center. But I'm not sure about that. We really
Someone
need to check on that.
Yeah. Film now that YouTube is the people spend half their lives on it. So Lucy, tell us what about the music. You know, it used to be a guy named Bill Page, who maybe he's listening out there in Austin, Texas. Oh, he's in Dripping Springs, I think, on his little farm, and he's got a radio show down there. He did used to do the music, and then he moved away, I guess, last year. You were the one who did the music?
Yeah, I did the music last year for the first time, trying to keep in line with Bill's reputation. His son, Will, continues to work with the festival. He worked with it last year, and it's helping me run sound this year. We've got a wonderful mix of artists who are going to be there this year. Everything ranging from a drum ensemble from Family Matters up here, an organization that's right up here. It's a youth drum ensemble.
Oh, yeah, Dan McNeil's
group, absolutely.
Yeah, he's been on the show a lot lately.
They give a wonderful burst to the beginning of the festival. They start everything off for the weekend for us. In addition to running sound for us, Will, you know, is an accomplished musician in his own right. And so he's going to be singing and playing. You know, he covers everything from pop and rock to he likes to sometimes do, kind of parody stuff. And he's amazing.
That kid
amazing
is a hell
presence.
Of a golfer, too, just
oh,
so everyone knows.
I
if
didn't
they're looking
know
for
that.
A local real good golfer.
Dan McNeil's group, Family Matters, the Roots of Rhythm, and Will, and Katie Scrantum is also a singer-songwriter who's going to be on Saturday. There's also a group that's called Crosscheck in Aisle 3. one of their members, Jeff Sweeten, actually used to work right here in the neighborhood. So it's a combination of dulcimer and viola and guitar. And it's this kind of music that, you know, you kind of close your eyes and, and you're really happy that you're at the beach. It's just kind of a wonderful,
you can close
really
your eyes
mood.
And paint.
Yeah. And then we
Blissed
have
out with your feet in the sand, barefoot in the
that's
sand.
That's right. That's right.
Bliss out. Right on. And after them on Saturday will be Misha Heron. She's an amazing singer-songwriter. It's right here in Chicago. She's on the south side. And closing out the Saturday will be the M.E.T.E.T., or the Marcus Evans Quintet. And Marcus Evans has been working in the Chicago area for a really long time. This project in particular kind of combines jazz or post bop era music from the 50s and 60s and music of today, you know, kind of hip hop stuff. And so that's on Saturday. And then should I keep going?
Keep going.
Keep going. All right. Then on Sunday, on Father's Day, we start out at noon with School of Rock.
Yeah. We have them here every now and then.
Which makes their presence all around the city, especially during the summer. It's a group of kids from the School of Rock, you know, from 8 to 18, and they rock it out. You know, it's really impressive. They're committed, and there's always tons of fun. After them will be Mundelein, which is a group of students from Loyola. Actually, I think either two of the five or maybe three of the five just graduated from Loyola.
You know, yeah. Katie and I both went to Mundelein.
Yeah, is that name a kind of a protest against Mundelein
not
being
there?
Yeah,
taken
right.
Over
the
by
missing,
Loyola?
The missing school.
You know, I haven't asked them that, but I will.
Well, maybe when there's gender equality, they'll have Loyola Mundelein instead of Loyola Marymount or Loyola New Orleans or wherever
they
got
a million Loyolas. My daughter went to Loyola, and she told me that her school ate my school. So I assume it's just gone.
The Pac-Man syndrome.
Well, actually, all the members of this this band are men.
Oh.
So let's hope they seem to have a good feminist consciousness.
When you think about it that
that's
way,
good.
That it works out even
all right,
better.
That's good.
And then, you know, it's a wonderful combination of guitar and just beautiful harmonies, you know, vocally. And there's a violin and drums and they call themselves folk rock. So it's a treat from them. After Mundelein is Jimmy Toko and the High Life Funkies.
That's a cool name.
Yeah, so we're going to get some wonderful High Life music with Jimmy's from Nigeria. And it's a band that they've been playing around for quite a while. And they headlined the Nigerian Festival here a few years in a row. And closing out Saturday will be my band, actually.
Yay!
My quartet. I've been making music around
so
town.
So you are the headliner, Lucy Smith.
She's the footliner.
I'm the exhausted organizer who's forced to play anyway. And this year, we actually have an MC for the music stage. Cheryl Corley has graciously...
Cheryl Corley, is from BEZ?
From NPR.
NPR,
yes.
Well...
So she's gonna MC. So the music is wonderfully eclectic, and it's from noon to 5 on both days. Music starts at noon, and you were usually done at 5 on both days.
Okay, that's good. The big music lineup for the Artist of the Wall Festival. This year, the theme is Barefoot in the Sand. It's next weekend, June 16th and 17th. And Kathy Pollack, tell us how people can contact you, the event, etc. I know that the pre-registration is closed, but people can get some information if they go to...
If they want to paint, they can sign up on Saturday morning at 9 a.m. The wall, by the way, is between Morris and Pratt Boulevard on the lakefront at Loyola Park. The website for rogerspark.com does have information on it for you. And also there is, to sign up on Saturday, they come and they put their name in, and then there's a lottery drawing for who gets to paint. So...
I may not be getting to paint this year.
Well,
if you put your name
in and you're a good boy, maybe they'll pull your name.
I'm going to be on the radio.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
Well, and just tell us briefly before we close this segment of the Live from the Heartland show on the 9th of June in the year 2012. How did this festival begin? How did it start?
This is where I need Katie Hogan.
We'll just give her some credit then.
Yeah. The festival started, from what I remember, and I may be wrong, as a neighborhood event, just some neighbors who got tired of seeing graffiti on the wall and got together, got permission from the park district, and so that they weren't also doing graffiti, and did some painting. And then it's just grown larger and larger every year, and we're still continuing to collect people, and it just is the most fun thing to do for Father's Day. Bring a picnic, sit in the park, and paint.
And you can always get food up at the Heartland Stand in the Sand, just a little bit north on that same day.
we should definitely mention that this is a program, an event, that's organized by the Loyola Park Advisory Council, which
that
at some point.
Sorry.
they're the blood, sweat, and tears.
And they haven't painted over last year's pictures yet.
Yeah, I believe the painting's being done on Monday.
So this weekend you can see what went up last year,
yeah,
and it's really pretty. And get it, because it'll be gone forever unless we get more photos.
That's right. You know, you work so hard on your painting, and you're so proud of yourself, but it does stay up for a whole year. You can bring your friends by later to see it, and then, boom, it's gone, and you start over.
Okay, let's have a big round of applause for Lucy Smith and Kathy Pollock, representing the Artist of the Wall. Thank you very much for coming on, and we'll see you around the neighborhood.
All right, thank you.
And I'll see you next weekend. Okay.
All right.
We're getting ready for our next segment. We got.